Good afternoon, everyone. It's your English class, and today we are going to study first chapter of unit second, the model millionaire. This chapter we are going to study. So in this chapter, five main characters are there. First is Huey Erskine. That is the protagonist of this chapter. Protagonist means the main character of this chapter, Huey Erskine. So second character is that is the girl, that is Laura Martin. Laura Martin is the daughter of the colonel. So you can see, so colonel is father of Laura Martin. So three main characters are there. First is Huey Erskine, Laura Martin, colonel. Fourth main character is Alan Trevor, that is the painter, and he is a friend of Huey Erskine. So this person is Huey Erskine, that is the girlfriend of Laura Martin. Next is Baron Hosberg. Baron Hosberg is a rich man, a rich person. So these five main characters are there in this chapter. Huey Erskine, the protagonist, means the main character, Laura Martin, daughter of Colonel, and would be wife of Huey Erskine, and Colonel, the father of Laura Martin. Alan Trevor is a friend of Huey Erskine, and he is a painter. Baron Hosberg is a rich man, is a rich person. Okay, so these five main characters are there. Now let's start to read the chapter. So, The Model Millionaire, written by Oscar Wilde. So let's warm up first. Leonardo da Vinci took 7 years to paint The Last Supper, which included the figures of Christ and his disciples. So Leonardo da Vinci was a painter, and he took approximate 7 years to Last Supper. It's a painting named The Last Supper. So he took approximate 7 years to paint this painting. And that was the masterpiece. In this, he figures of Christ and his disciples, right? Then, after many interviews, he chose one man whose face showed the innocence and beauty to model for Christ. So, he took many interviews. After that, he selected one face that is quite innocent and that is quite suitable to the model Christ. He interviewed many persons for this. Okay. Next. After 6 years, he again interviewed many men to model for Judas, and finally selected an unpleasant and cruel looking prisoner. After painting was over, the prisoner revealed that he was the same person who had posed for Leonardo as the model for Christ 6 years ago. So Leonardo da Vinci, after six years, again conducted some interview for the model of Judas. He organized many interviews, and he selected the same person. That time he was a prisoner, and then the prisoner revealed this point that he was the same person who was selected by you before 6 years for the role of Christ. So in the last line, what do you learn from this story? Discuss your observation in class. So you have to discuss this observation. Means basically we want to say that, so painters use their outer appearance. They don't see that what is their internal character. Okay, so this story is same regarding this. Okay, now let's read the story line by line. Let's start. Unless one is wealthy, there is no use in being a charming person. So author says that if you are wealthy and you are not wealthy means you are rich and you are not smart, so that's okay. But you are smart, but you are not wealthy, you are not rich, that is not good. You should be rich. Author says like this, right? Wait. Okay. It is better to have a permanent income than to be fascinating. Fascinating means attractive, charming. So author says that it is better you should have permanent income. Means like you are earning something that is good, that is better than you are looking fascinating or charming. So charming, you are charming, attractive or fascinating, it doesn't matter, but you should have permanent income. Right? Next line, author says that these are the great truths of modern life which Hubie Erskine never realized. So author says that it is the truth of modern life. In this, the character Hubie Erskine did not understand this matter. Poor Hubie. When his father died, he had left him no money at all. So author says that when the father of the Hubie Erskine died, he left no money. Hubie lived on £200, £200 a year that an old aunt gave him. So he had no legacy. So that's why Hubie Erskine's aunt gave him only £200 per year to survive. Next line, he had tried his hand at various jobs but did not like any of them. So he tried to do many jobs, but ultimately he did not like any job. Ultimately, he became nothing, a delightful, unsuccessful young man with a perfect profile. Profile means here face, no profession. So he has no profession, but his profile means his face was good. He was delightful, but he was unsuccessful person because he has no profession. He was jobless. He was looking good, but lack of profession, he was not good, in not good condition. Next line, to make matters worse, he was in love. So first problem is that he was poor. Second problem was that he was in love. The girl he loved was Laura Martin, the daughter of a retired colonel. So he used to love a girl. The girl name was Laura Martin, and that was the daughter of a retired colonel. They were the handsomest couple in the London and had not a penny piece between them. So author says that they were very handsome. They were handsomest couple in the London. Despite it, there is no peace between them. The colonel was very fond of Hughie, but would not hear of any engagement. Means colonel liked the Hughie Erskine, but he was not in favor of their engagement. You know why? Because Hughie Erskine was a poor person. Come to me, my boy, when you have got £10,000 of your own, and we will see about it, he used to say. So colonel used to say that if you earn £10,000 by yourself, then I will think about your marriage with my daughter. So colonel said like this. One morning, Hubie dropped in to see a great friend of his, Alan Trevor. So Alan Trevor was a friend of Hubie Erskine. One morning, Hubie went there to meet him. Trevor was an artist. So he was an artist, means he was a painter. He was a strange, rough fellow with a freckled face and red, ragged beard. So he had a ragged beard and his face was freckled. Freckled face means face with small and brownish spots. Means koi chote chote face pe dane hona, dhabbe hona. However, when he took up the brush, he was a real master, and his pictures were eagerly sought after. Sought after means be in demand, means when something is in demand, so that is called sought after. So author says that by appearance he does not look a good person, but when he takes the brush, so by his painting, after seeing his painting, we can say that he is the best painter in that scenario, right? So these four difficult words are written here. Dear students, you have to learn these words. Along with this, you have to write these words in your notebook too. So first word is fascinating. Fascinating means charming, attractive, akarshak. Profile means here a person face from sight, yani kisi person ka face. Freckled face means face with many small brownish spots. Means having many brownish spots on the face, that is called freckled face. Sought after means in demand, everyone's favorite. Okay. Next page. So dear students, before explaining the next page, I want to ask some internal questions so that I can come to know that you are listening to me or not carefully. So some internal question I'm going to put on the behalf of first page reading. So please tell me, please give me the answer of first question. First question is that you need to raise your hand for this question. What is the name of the protagonist means main character? What is the name of the protagonist? Who will let me know? Raise your hand if you can give the answer. What is the name of the main character? Raise your hand if you can give the answer. It's a very simple. Dear students, try to give the answer. I can see no one has raised his or her hand. It's a very simple question. Dear students, raise your hand if you know the answer. It's a very simple. Okay, yes. Akshita will let us know. Akshita, what's the name of the main character?
Sir, Yubi Erskine.
Yubi Erskine. That's the name of the main character or protagonist. Protagonist means main character. Very good. Right answer. So it means you have been listening to me very carefully. Good, very good. Right answer. Next question on the behalf of the first page understanding. What is the name of the daughter of the colonel? So you need to tell me the name of the daughter of the colonel. So who will let me know? That's a very simple, very easy question. Lavisha will let me know. Lavisha, please tell us what's the name of the daughter of the colonel. Lavisha, can you tell? You are audible. I think it's internet problem from her side. Nikunj, you tell me please. Nikunj.
Laura Martin.
Laura Martin. Yes, very good. Right answer. Laura Martin, that's the name of the daughter of the colonel. Very good. Right answer. Next question. What is the name of the painter? So one painter was described. He was friend of Yubi Erskine. So can you tell me what's the name of that painter? That artist? Ansh will let us know. Ansh, please tell me.
Sir, Alan Trevor.
Yes, Alan Trevor. Very good. Right answer. Alan Trevor is that person who is a good painter in this chapter. Very good. Right answer. Next question is that according to the author, which is more important, be a charming fellow or being a rich person? According to the author, which is more important, being a charming fellow or being a rich person? Ameer hona jyada acha hai ya charming hona, akarshak hona, sundar hona jyada acha hai? You need to tell us according to the author. Who will let me know? Yes. Reed, please tell me. Okay. Akshita, you please tell me. Akshita.
Sir Reed.
Sorry?
Sir Reed.
Rich, no, yes, right answer. Rich, like according to the author, we can say rich is more important than to be charming fellow. Very good. Being a rich person. Very good. Right answer. Good. Next question. How much amount did Hughie get from his aunt? How much amount did Hughie get from his aunt? So amount you have to let me know. So who will tell me? Who will give me the right answer? Shubhyank, you please tell me. Dear students, if you do not want to give the answer, don't, so please don't raise your hand. Nikunj, you please tell me.
Sir, 200 pounds.
200 pounds. Very good. Right answer. So, last question. How much amount did the colonel say to you for earning? How much amount did the colonel say to Huey for earning? So what was that amount which was said by the colonel? So who will let me know? Lavisha, please tell me. Lavisha, you have raised your hand. Please tell me what was that amount?
Sir, 10,000 pound.
10,000 pounds. Very good. Yes, well, you have given the right answer. 10,000 pounds. It was the amount. Very good. So, dear students, in this way, I will keep asking the question. This question will be internal question on the behalf of the chapter reading. So, I can ask any time such type of questions. So, listen me carefully. Okay. Now, please down your hand and let's read the next chapter, next page of this chapter. Okay. Yes. When Huey came in, he found Trevor putting the finishing touches to a wonderful life-size picture of a beggar man. The beggar himself was standing on a raised platform in a corner of the studio. So when Huey Ruskind went to meet his friend, Alan Trevor, so Alan Trevor was painting a picture of a beggar, and beggar was standing on a raised platform, right? In the corner of the studio. He was bent old man with a wrinkled face and the saddest expression. Right? So that old man was in bent position and his face was wrinkled and he was giving the saddest expression by his face. Over his shoulders was flung a coarse brown cloak, all the tears and tatters. So on his shoulder, there was a cloak. Cloak means labada, purana kapda. That was in very bad condition. That was tears and tatters. Tears and tatters means like which is torn. Right? His thick boots were patched. Means his boots were repaired. His shoes were repaired. And with one hand, he leant on a rough stick, while with the other, he held out his battered head for alms. So in one hand, he was having a stick. And in second hand, means like in another hand, he was having a head, battered head. Battered means which has been used for a long time, that is battered. Okay. What an amazing model, whispered Huey, as he shook hands with his friends. So as he shook hands with his friend, Alan Trevor, he said, means Huey Ruskind said in very low voice, the model is very amazing, wonderful. How miserable he looks. How much does a model get for sitting? Asked Huey. Then Huey asked that, he's a very miserable. And how much a model get just for being a, just for sitting there and you are painting his painting. So how much does a model get? Then a shilling an hour. So a shilling is a European like currency, that British currency we can say. And how much do you get from your picture, Alan? Then he asked from Alan, so if a model get only 1 shilling for an hour, and how much you get? Then he says that, oh, for this I get 2,000 guineas. 2,000 guineas means 1,000, one guinea is equal to 21 shillings. And he is saying, I get 2,000 guineas. Okay, so 1 guinea is equal to 21 shilling. That's the British currency. Well, I think the model should have a percentage, cried Huey, laughing. they work quite as hard as you do. Then he says that you should give the percentage to your model, because how much hard work you do, the same hard work your model do. Nonsense. Why look at the trouble of laying on a paint alone and standing all day long at one's easel? It is all very well to be for you to talk, but I am assure you that there are moments when art almost becomes manual labor. But you mustn't chatter. I am very busy, so keep quiet. As like Huey says that you should give some percentage on this point, Alan Travers says that why you're talking nonsense? Are you stupid? So can't you see our labor? We have to put a lot of effort for this. Every time we have to stand with the easel. Easel means that is a stand. This is easel, right? And we have to put manual labor in this. And now please shut your mouth. Don't chatter with me. Can't you see I'm quite busy? So like this, the Alan Trevor said to Hubert Aspang. Wait, please. After some time, a helper came in and told Trevor that Framemaker wanted to speak to him. As they both were standing there, so the helper of Alan Trevor came there and he told to Trevor that one person has come here and he is a Framemaker and he want to talk to you. Don't run away, Huey, he said as he went out. I'll be back in a moment. So as Alan Trevor started going out from that studio, so he said to Huey, please don't go from here. I'm just coming back. The old beggar took advantage of Trevor's absence to rest for a moment on a wooden bench that was behind him. So as Alan Trevor went there, that beggar took the advantage of sitting there. So the beggar sat there on the wooden bench, which was just behind him. Wait. He looked so forlorn and wrenched that Huey could not help pitying him and felt in his pocket to see what money he had. So by his appearance, that beggar was looking quite sad and wretched. So that's the wretched. Wretched means like who is extremely sad. So by this, it was appearing. Huey could not help himself to pay the pity on that beggar, and felt in his pocket to see what money he had. So he wanted to give something to that beggar. So Huey like started finding in his pocket. All he could find was a gold coin, a sovereign. A sovereign is a gold coin in the British. So he found that gold coin, means sovereign, in his pocket. Poor old fellow, he thought to himself. He wants it more than I do, but it means no taxi for next 2 weeks. And he walked across the studio and slipped the sovereign into the beggar's hand. So Huey Erskine paid the pity on that beggar because the beggar was in very bad condition. So it appeared that he is in very bad condition and he's sad. So Huey Erskine wanted to give him something. So he find in his pocket. So he found one gold coin. And so he thought that if I give this gold coin to this beggar, so for 2 weeks, I will have to walk because it's a taxi fare for 2 weeks. But he found that the beggar is in need, in more need. So he gave that sovereign, that gold coin to beggar's hands. And he went from there. The old man looked surprised and smiled faintly. Then, thank you, sir, he said, thank you, as the old man, as the old beggar. Got that gold coin, he smiled and he was looking surprised and he said, thank you so much. The driver arrived and Hughie took his leave, blushing a little at what he had done. So that time, Hughie was blushing because whatever he had done, that was wonderful for him. And then Trevor arrived and he went from there. He spent the day with the Laura, got a charming scolding for his extravagance and had to woke him. Extravagance means like when we spend something extra, that is called extravagance, as we say in Hindi, fijul kharchi, that is called extravagance. So when he met to Alora Martin, so she scolded him very much for his extravagance because he had spent one gold coin. That night he met Trevor at the ballet club. So there is a ballet club. He met to Trevor. Well, Alan, did you get the picture finished all right? He said. So he said to Alan, so Alan, have you finished that picture? All right. Finished and framed, my boy. Answer Trevor. Trevor said that I have finished it and I have framed it. By the way, you have made a conquest. And he says that you have made a conquest. You have done something. Right. So dear students, on the behalf of this understanding, on the behalf of second page reading, I want to put some questions. And these will be the internal question, and you need to raise your hand if you know the answer. Our next question is that whose picture was Alan painting? Whose picture was Alan painting? So please tell me whose picture was Alan painting. Yes, Anish will give me the answer. Anish, you please tell me. Anish, please give me the answer.
The old man.
Old man, old beggar, we can say. Yes, very good right answer. Opa beggar, Baron Hosberg. Old man, we can also say. Very good right answer. It means you have been listening to me. Next, what was the beggar having in his hands? So what were in the hands of the beggar? So who will let me know? Manishita, you please tell me. What was the beggar having in his hand?
Sir, cap.
Cap, and in one hand he was having the cap. What is in the other hand? Okay, I tell you. He was having a stick and an old hat. Very good, right answer. Next question, how much does a model get for sitting? How much does a model get for sitting? Who will give me the answer to this question? Ansh, you please tell me.
Sir, a shilling and hour.
Very good, right answer. 1 shilling and hour. Yes, very good, right answer. Next question. How much does Alan get for a painting? How much does Alan get for a painting? Who can give me the answer? Akshita, you please tell me.
Sir, 2,000 guineas.
2,000 guineas. Very good, right answer. 2,000 guineas, that is equal to 42,000 shillings. Very good, right answer. Next, who wanted to speak to Alan when he was painting? Who wanted to speak to Alan when he was painting? So who can give me the answer? Let me see. Manishita, you please tell me. Manishita. Okay. Sai Pratik.
Sir, Baron Hosberg.
Baron Hosberg. That is the frame maker. That incident was described. Someone came there. He wanted to speak to Alan when he was painting. So once is a frame maker came there and he wanted to speak to that Alan Trevor. Okay, but you have tried very well. Good. Next question. What did the old beggar get from Huey? What did the old beggar get from Huey? Or you can say, what did Huey give to the old beggar? So who will give me the answer? Sai Prateek. Sai Prateek, unmute yourself and give me the answer.
Good afternoon, sir.
Very good afternoon. What can be the answer, Sai Prateek?
Sir, a gold coin.
A gold coin. Very good. A sovereign. Very good. Right answer. Last question. Who gave the charming scolding for the extravagance? Who gave the charming scolding for the extravagance? Who will let me know? Nikunj. Nikunj, can you tell me?
Laura Merton.
Very good. Right answer. Laura Merton gave him charming scolding for the extravagance. Very good. So in this way, dear students, I will keep asking you. Basically, this question will be internal question.